Okay, well, unfortunately, when I came to unmute the microphone after the test had completed, it seems that I'd unfortunately somehow stopped the recording. And I've got the test results missing. It's all deleted now, unfortunately, but suffice to say, everything passed. There were a few unexpected passes, but that's not a problem. Everything else was fine. So I only just noticed as I was starting this Barclay DB package. So I'll unzip this again and carry on from there. So this package is called DB, not Barclay DB. And what I'll do is I'll put the mute on for the remainder of the building. Obviously I'll capture everything in case you want to see anything in particular. But other than that, I might unmute the microphone for anything interesting. Otherwise, probably won't hear my voice until towards the end of the building of the packages. So get that going. Right, now I'm going to install grub as I've just compiled it. But we've got to do something slightly different because we've already got a boot directory with or a boot partition with other stuff in it, and grub already exists as well. So I've installed it. What I need to do now is to mount dev sta2 at boot, and I'll check to make sure I've got the right partition. Yep, there it is. I don't need to do the make the boot grub because that already exists, as you can see there. ls-l/boot grub, and there's the contents of it. So what we're going to do now is just to overwrite the stage 1 and stage 2 files with the presumably updated, I presume this is a newer version of grub, with this command here. And in fact, if I put in an I there, it will ask us if we wish to overwrite those files, which just confirms that they basically are being overwritten. So you can see they've got June 5th date at 2:30. That one's 512. That one's 98986. So let's see how that changes. So both those files have been overwritten. Let's now look at the files again. And you can see, well, stage 1, that's probably a boot sector, maybe. I don't know. But certainly the stage 2 has increased. And you can see the date has been updated as well, date and time. And then finally, it says to also copy the E2FS stage 1.5 file as well, which is that file there. So that's going to get updated as well. So we need to repeat this command here with the E2FS stage 1 and put that into boot grub. And yes, we do want to overwrite it. So again, this will probably be updated, and I guess this will be slightly bigger in size. And yeah, it's increased slightly. And again, it's got today's date and time. So that's grub done for now. I'll unmount boot, I think, for the time being, just to be sure nothing gets wiped out there. And I'll carry on now with the remaining packages. Okay, so that's the end of all the packages apart from the Linux kernel itself. I'm going to just do this debugging symbols bit. And hope it doesn't trash everything. So we need to log out. Let's see what's mounted here. Shouldn't be anything extra. No, so let's log out. Log back in again. So this hasn't got the... Sorry, this has got the tools as environment again. And then it says the binaries and libraries can safely be stripped. And it says a strip all option can be used on user bin and sbin, so I'm not going to do that because the disk space is not very tight at all. So cleaning up, and it says from now on, when re-entering the trut environment after exiting, use the following modified trut commands. So this is the one that hasn't got the tools directory in the path. Whereas I think the previous one did. Yeah, it's got it at the... Oh, sorry, we were running the bash in tools in that one. That's right. So at the moment, the current environment we're using is not relying on tools at all.